Good afternoon, students. Yesterday the topic was electricity, and we have just done some of the numericals of NCERT, and there was a question: what is the difference between resistance and resistivity? This question was asked by Anshika. That was question was asked, and already I told her that when I'll take my next lecture. In the starting of the lecture, I'll explain. Now, students, resistance and resistivity. Resistance mean to oppose the flow of electric current. Resistance mean to oppose the flow of electric current. As per Ohm's law, R is, that is the V is equal to IR, and R is equal to V by I. Resistance. Now, student, resistivity. It is the property. Resistivity is the property or the characteristics of the materials, that how much it will allow to flow the electric current from that material. For different materials have different resistivity. Say yesterday I taken the example while we were doing the numericals in the table given in your NCERT. It is 12.2 table which is given in your NCERT. Now silver has the lowest resistivity, means 1.6. That is the resistivity of the silver. It is 1.6 into 10 raised to the power minus 8 ohm meter resistivity of the silver. Now student, what it means? The resistivity, whereas the resistivity of the mercury, it was some around 94 into 10 raised power 9 minus 8 ohm meter. Now student, if you compare both of silver and the mercury, now the mercury has the resistivity 94 into 10 raised power minus 8, whereas the silver 1.6 into 10 raised power minus 8 ohm meter. Now student, the materials which is having the low resistivity is known as the good conductor. So the conductivity of the that material, it depends on the resistivity, or we can say that resistivity, it is the property of the material, that how much current is flowing through that conductor. Either it is the current is flowing, either it is opposing the flow of electric current. If the resistivity is high, it will not allow to pass the electric current. To that means resistivity is high. So if the resistivity is low, it will allow the electric current to pass through. Is it clear, students? Now today our topic is the how we can connect this resistance in the series and parallel. What will be the total resistance when they are connected in series and when they are connected in parallel? Their combinations of the resistance in series and parallel. So this is a very, very important topic today. And based on this, so many numericals also will solve. Now topic is, students, the combinations of the resistance. Combination of the resistance. Sometime you may find word resistor meaning same, resistance or resistors same, but ultimately series and parallel. There are two types of the combinations. One is a series, number two it is a parallel. What it means, series and parallel, students? So if I got say three resistance, for example R1, R2 and R3, now I want to connect them in series in electric circuit. How I will connect them in the series and how the three resistance will be connected in parallel? First, simply I'll tell how the series and the parallel the resistance will be connected. Then I'll draw the diagrams. In the diagram, so all the components will be shown, all the three resistance I will show, how they are connected in series and parallel, and what will be the total resistance when they are connected in series and when they are connected in parallel. The net resistance or the total resistance in series and total resistance in parallel when they are connected. Now students, when they are connected in the series, the total resistance, it will be R1 plus R2 plus R3. When they are connected in parallel, it will be 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 plus 1 by R3. And how this formula drives when the total, when the resistance, they are connected in series. So the total resistance or the net resistance, how it can be calculated, this derivation is there for this, for parallel also there is a derivation is there. So I'll both the series and the parallel, I'll explain how to calculate the total resistance. Now students, for series, say there are three resistances. One is like R1, second one is R2, third one is R3. Here I will write down R1, R2, R3. Now three resistance, R1, R2, R3. Now they are connected in series. Is it clear, students? If I want to connect them in the parallel, now one resistance, second resistance, third resistance. Now students, they are connected in parallel, R1, R2, R3. Is it clear, students? Now the three resistance, R1, R2, and R3, they are connected in parallel. This type of the combinations will be there in the circuit diagram. Now I'll draw the circuit diagrams by showing how these resistance can be connected in series and parallel in the electric circuit. Now students, I'll draw the diagram. The diagram already it is given in your NCERT book. Same diagram we'll draw. It is on the page number 210. Page number 210. Now student, they have shown the three resistance. R1, R2, R3. Three resistance. Clear, students? Now I'll add ammeter also and voltmeter also. Ammeter for measuring the current and voltmeter it will be for measuring the potential difference. Now student, ammeter I'll connect in the series. Here ammeter. Now ammeter, and here is a battery combination of two or more cell. Here is a positive terminal, here is a negative terminal. Now students, battery, now there will be key also. Key, battery, ammeter. Now students, I will connect the voltmeter, and voltmeter it is always connected in the parallel of the circuit. Parallel is, now it is, voltmeter will be connected here. Now voltmeter will be connected here, students, positive, negative. And with this I'll complete the diagram. Now students, this is the circuit diagram, and I have shown the path of flow of electric current also. Students, resistance, three resistance, R1, R2, R3, they are given. I have connected them in the series, R1, R2, R3. Clear, students? Now I have connected the voltmeter, which is always connected in the parallel. Already when I was explaining the potential difference, and potential difference is measured with the help of the voltmeter, and voltmeter is always connected in the parallel of the electric circuit, And already I have explained to you also that why the voltmeter is always connected in the parallel. So student, here also we have connected the voltmeter in the parallel due to its high resistance. Clear, students? Now ammeter is also there for measuring the current. It is connected in the series due to its low resistance. Battery, it is a combination of the cells with the three cells, positive terminal, then negative, positive, negative, and positive, negative. It is starting that bigger line, it is indicating the positive terminal. Shorter line, it is indicating the negative terminal, students. So combination of the three cells, that's why it is known as the battery. Here I've shown the key or plug, I can say switch also. Because when the key will be closed or switch will be on, that time the current will flow. When the key is open, it is not closed, or when the switch is off positions, that time current will not flow through the circuit and we will not get any reading in the circuit. Is it clear, students? For obtaining the reading in the circuit, the circuit should be closed and this key should be closed and it should allow the current to pass through. Now students, I'll go into detail of that, how I have shown the path of the electric current. Now current will start flowing from the positive terminal to the negative terminals, starting from positive and it will end to the negative terminal. Now student, there are two types of current. One is the conventional current, second one is the electronic current. Conventional current always flows from the positive terminal to the negative terminal. It is always flowing through the outer circuit. The current which flows through the outer circuit from positive terminal to the negative terminal, that is called conventional current. And the current inside the circuit, which flows, that is called from negative terminal to the positive terminal, that is called electronic current. Now here I have shown the conventional currents, but electronic current, the path of the electronic current is, students, from negative terminal to the positive terminal, that is inside the circuit. It, the current which flows, that is called electronic current. Now I think that diagram is clear. I have explained all the components which are already there in this circuit diagram. Now student, next step will be, this is the series combinations. Now how we can calculate the total resistance when they are connected in the series. Now students, the law of combinations says that the net resistance R is equal to R1 plus R2 plus R3. So how to obtain this formula when they are connected in series? Okay, series connections of resistances. Now three resistances connected in series and the resultant will be R is equal to R1 plus R2 plus R3. How, students, it will be, how the formula can be obtained. Now student, when the three resistances, they are connected in series, now their voltage will be, now the voltage will be, here it will be V1 and V2 and V3. Now total voltage will be, now V will become as a V1 plus V2 plus V3. Is it clear, students? The net voltage will be V is equal to V1 plus V2 plus V3. Is it clear, student? Here, along with this resistance, it will be V1, here V2 and V3. Is it clear, students? Now, according to the Ohm's law, already you know the Ohm's law. Ohm's law says that V is equal to IR. Here I'll write down according to Ohm's law. According to or as per Ohm's law. Now I'll put the value in place of V, I'll put the value IR. Now IR is equal to, here I'll write down in place of V, IR1 plus IR2 plus IR3. Now students, remember one thing, students, when there are three resistors, they are connected in series, or any number of the resistors they are connected in series, their current remains same. Remember, the current will remain same when the resistance will connected in the series. This most important point. The current will remain same. That's why I have shown IR1, IR2, IR3. Now, students, I can take I common from the right hand side. If I take the I common, now inside it will be R1 plus R2 plus R3. Now, here is I in the left hand side. I can write down R is equal to R1 plus R2 plus R3. So this is my net result which was required. As per the law of the combinations of when the resistance they are connected in series. Again, student, I'll explain the circuit diagram. Already I explained to you in details. Next step is now potential difference. It will be V is equal to V1 plus V2 plus V3. Now, student, as per Ohm's law, V is equal to IR. I put the value here. I'll put the value in place of V. I can write down IR. Here, in place of V1, I can write down IR1 and V2, IR2, V3, IR3. Now, I'll take the I common and inside the bracket, I'll write down R1 plus R2 plus R3. And I is common in the left hand side and the right hand side also. Right hand side I and left hand side I both will get cancelled and the net result will be R is equal to R1 plus R2 plus R3. This is the required result when the resistance here three resistance. If they are four, then R1 plus R2 plus R3 plus R4. Any number of the resistance they are connected in series. Now same. R1 plus R2 plus R3 and so on. Is it clear, student, this concept? How the combinations of the resistance in a circuit when they are connected in series and what will be their net resultant? Our next topic is when the what will be the net resistance when they are connected in the parallel. Next diagram which I am going to draw, that is a net resistance when there are three resistances, they are connected in parallel. If you want to note down, student, please you can note down. Otherwise, I'll start with the next topic, how the combination of the resistance when they are connected in parallel. Is it clear, students? Now, next topic is the combinations of the resistance when they are connected in parallel. So I'll draw another diagram, students. Now, combinations of the resistance when they are connected in parallel. Topic is combinations of the resistance. Combinations of resistances or resistors when connected in parallel. When connected in parallel, what will be the net result? So the formula will be 1 by R is equal to 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 plus 1 by R3. This is the formula, student, and we'll drive this formula same way how we have drawn the formula for series also. First, we'll draw the diagram, circuit diagram, students, for combinations of the resistance when they are connected in parallel. Now, students, for parallel combinations, I'll draw the diagram. Same three resistance, R1, R2, now, student, these are the three resistance, R1, R2, and R3. They are connected in parallel. Is it clear, students? Now, I want to connect the voltmeter. Voltmeter will be connected in the parallel. Here, I'll connect the voltmeter also. Is it clear, students? The voltmeter, it is used for measuring the potential difference. Now, same way, I'll complete the circuit diagram, students. Here I will connect the ammeter also Yes, students. I'll complete the diagram. Here is key. It is a battery. It is a voltmeter. Now this is the circuit diagram, students. Circuit diagram. Now, student, three resistors R1, R2, R3, and they are the they are connected in the parallel. Is it clear, student? They are connected in parallel, and ammeter it is connected in series. Voltmeter is connected in parallel. There is a battery. I have shown there is a key. K. That is it is in the close. Now current start flowing. That's from positive terminal to the negative terminal. Conventional currents will flow, and inside electronic current will flow. Now, students, according to the Ohm's law, here, sorry, here again I'll use the formula of Ohm's law. Now, students, when the resistance they are in the connected in the parallel, that time the current divides. That time the current divides, and current it is the I is equal to. I1 plus I2 plus I3. The current is divided. The current is divided, students. It is I is equal to I1 plus I2 plus I3. Now, again, according to the Ohm's law, or as per the Ohm's law, I is equal to V by R. And I1 it is equal to V by R1 and I2 is equal to V by R2 and I3 V by R3 because when the resistance they are connected in the parallel that time their voltage remains same. Is it clear? When they are in series current remains same, when they are connected in the parallel then voltage remains same. Now students, again only just I have applied the formula of the Ohm's law, V is equal to IR or V by R is equal to I. Is it clear, students? Now, by putting the value of I, V by R, here I1, V by R1, I2, V by R2, and I3, V by R3. Now, again, I'll take the common V from here. Now, if V is taken common, student, 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 plus 1 by R3. Here, V this side and that's both the side, left hand side and right hand side, both will get cancelled. Now, student, my net result is 1 by R is equal to 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 plus 1 by R3. This is the required result. The combinations of the three resistance when they are connected in parallel. Is it clear, students? Very, very important topic, very important concept. Now, what will be the total resistance when they are connected in series or when they are connected in parallel? So when they are connected in series, students, the net resistance is R is equal to R1 plus R2 plus R3. When they are connected in parallel, 1 by R is equal to 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 plus 1 by R3. Whenever the three resistance they are connected in parallel, their net resistance will become less. And when the resistance will become less, the current will uplift or current will enhance or current will become more. When the three resistance they are connected in series. Now students, practically I'll show how the resistance they are connected in series. For example, I got two resistance here, one resistance and second resistance. I want to connect them series like this. I'll connect them in a series, student. This is a series combinations of the two resistance. Now, if I want to this combine, or if that's in the parallel combinations in the circuit, now one resistance is like this, and second resistance will be like this, student. So there, it will be like this. R1 and R2. If one more resistance is there, I can say one more resistance R1, R2, and I can keep R3 also. This is parallel combination and this is series combinations. Is it clear, student? Concept must be clear to you. Now we'll go further for this, students. Now there are some of the numericals are given, and even though some of the NCERT questions are also in the first, I'll go through the examples which are given in your NCERT book. Then I will go further for the NCERT questions. You can note down up to this. If you want to note down this diagram and these explanations very well, you can note down. So our next will be the examples which are given in your NCERT books. I'll go through the examples, how to solve these examples, then further for the NCERT questions and the diagram, circuit diagram. I'll explain. Now, students, very, very important question. Now we are going to discuss. That's a page number 212 of your book. That's a example 12.7. I'll read it out, the statement. First, I'll read the statement. Then, what are the givens in that statement? I'll write down and how to solve this type of the numericals. If these numerical, this type of numericals are being asked in the exams, how to solve this type of numericals. Now, student, I'll read the statement. The statement is like this: an electric lamp whose resistance is 20 ohm and a conductor of 4 ohm. Clear, students? They have given the electric lamp. The resistance of the electric lamp, it is 20 ohm, understood. The conductor's resistance is 4 ohm, are connected to the 6 volt battery. That potential difference of, that's the battery, it is given as a 6 volt. Calculate A part, the total resistance of the circuit. Now the current through the circuit, and number C part, the potential difference across the electric lamp and the conductor. There are 3 parts of this question. First, students, I'll draw the diagram of this statement, what it says. As per the statement, yes, students, now, as per the statement the given in this question, so I'll draw the diagram, students. This is the symbol of the bulb or lamp. Now, students, here they have given the 20 ohm value. This is 4 ohm. Is it clear, students? Now, again, there's a battery source of positive terminal and the negative terminal. Now, 6 volt means there will be for each, if I'll take the example of each, that's for 1.5. Now, it means I require 4 cells. Now 1.5 volt is the potential difference of one cell. Now if I will multiply with the 4, then it will be the 6 volt. Now, student, I'll draw the 6 cells, 1, 2, then next one is a 3, next one is a 4. Now, students, 1, 2, 3, 4, I'll write down 1, 2, 3, 4, 1.5 into 4, now it is a 6 volt. Is it clear, student? I'll put the ammeter also. I'll put the ammeter also in this, and there's a one keys out there, and I'll complete the circuit diagram. Now, students, current will flow and the bulb will start glowing if the circuit is closed. What it says, the statement, the resistance of the lamp, it is given as a 20 ohm. Yes, given. Now the resistance of the other conductor, it is given as a 4 ohm. When they are connected in series, now their net resistance will be R is equal to R1 plus R2, means R1 is equal to R1 plus R2 students means 4 ohm plus 20, it is equal to 24 ohm. So first answer is their net resistance, when these two resistances they are connected in series, their net resistance is 24 ohm. Is it clear, students? Now next is the next what it is they are asking. Now the total potential difference is 6 volt. Now potential difference is now V is equal to 6 volt and R is 24 ohm. Now students, according to Ohm's law, V is equal to IR, and if I want to calculate I means V by R. V it is given as 6 and it is R is given as 24. That is means 6 by 24. If I 6 1 4 1 by 4, it is 0.25 ampere. 0.25 ampere is my net current that which will flow through this two resistance. Now students, the value of current is 0.25. is it clear, student? Now the third part what it says. Now students, I have to calculate the value of V across the lamp. If I want to calculate the potential difference across this lamp, now students, formula is equal to V is equal to IR. Now I is equal to 0.25 and the value of this resistance, it is 20 ohm, and when I'll multiply with the 0.25 into 20, now I'll get here, I can write down decimal, I'll remove zero, cancel 25 and 55, I'll get the 5 volt. Means the potential difference across this will be 5 volt. Is it clear, students? Now, again, that's if potential difference is 6 volt, students, and the current value is 0.25, then my net result will be, I'll use the formula V is equal to IR. If it is of the 6 volt and the I is equal to 0.25 into R, so the value of R will be 6 divided by 0.25. If I will solve this, 6 by 25 by 100. Now 100 into 6 divided by 20 divided by 25. 25 and the 25, 25 4 is 100, and 4 into 6, it is 24 ohm. Again, students, the answer is 24, which already we have calculated when the two resistances they are connected in series. Is it clear, students? Now you have to solve the numericals which are given on the page number 213. In the first questions, very, very simple questions. Only you have to draw the diagram. How to draw the diagram? I'll read the statements. There are three the resistance. They are given 5 ohm, 8 ohm, and 12 ohm in the given. And only you have to collect this 2 volt cells. Then with when they are connected in series. Now student, you have to draw the diagram also. Is it clear, students? Now each they have given means you will draw the, say, 5 ohm resistance, that 2 volt is required for, again that another resistance for 8 ohm, 2 again for 12, again 2, means you will make the 3 cells for diagram. And the next, in the second questions which is given, again the diagram will remain same. The total voltage will be, there are 2 volt each cell, then multiply with the 3. Generally it is 1.5, but here they have given the 2 volt. So 2 multiply with the 3, it will be 6 volt, and the total resistance will be 5 plus 8 plus 12 when they are series. 5 plus 8 plus 12, 13 plus 12, that is 25. Now reading in the ammeter, by you will use the formula Ohm's law. I calculate kar lijiyega. You can calculate the value of I, you can calculate the value of V. Now voltmeter and ammeter reading, that will be the reading of the ammeter and the voltmeter. So try to solve these questions, NCERT questions, students. So if you are having any doubt, please you can ask me.